रोड, विनेश सिंह, amplifier, what is an amplifier and how it is working. So actually in the last video we have seen the basic characteristics of an amplifier. Then in this video we are going to see how transistor behave as an amplifier. So already I told you transistor has mainly two applications. One is it can act as a switch, second one it can act as an amplifier. And also you know, for common emitter, not only common emitter, all configuration of transistor have input characteristics and output characteristics. Normally we are using common emitter configuration of transistor for amplification, and its output characteristics, that is output voltage versus output current, by keeping input current is constant, that is output voltage VC versus output current IC, by keeping input current IP is constant. That graph is shown here. This graph have three region. One is saturation, second one active, third one is cutoff. In saturation region, one transistor, whatever the configuration, common emitter, common base or common collector, in saturation region it will behave as a on switch. In cutoff region it will behave as an off switch. And between these two region, saturation and cutoff region, there is one region, it is known as active region, and in that region it will behave as an amplifier. So we can see how transistor behave as an amplifier. So to understand that one, we can take this diagram. This is the common emitter amplifier configuration of an NPN transistor. There, for namesake, I have taken VBB is 1 volt. That is input voltage to the transistor is 1 volt. And RB resistance is 1 kilo ohm. Then you can calculate what is the input current. That is, I am not going to in detail calculation in applying KVL. To understand basic concept of amplifier, if you are going to apply KVL, you have to consider VB voltage across here like that. But that is concerned, we are neglecting that one. Then VBB by 1 kilo ohm, that is 1 milliampere. Then this 1 milliampere, imagine that is somewhat here, that is less than IB1. Less than IB1, somewhat here, that 1 milliampere. Then you can see it is in cutoff. Cutoff means transistor behave as an open circuit. It won't permit current to flow from emitter to collector, or charge carriers collector to emitter. Current in NPN configuration, current flow from collector to emitter. Okay, it will block by this transistor because it will be both junction in reverse bias. Since both junction are reverse bias, that is emitter base junction and base collector junction is in reverse bias, it will behave as an open circuit. Then if you are going to apply KVL here, voltage across these two terminal, this one normally we are saying as VCE. So voltage across these two terminal, that is VCE, VCE. Say here it is minus and above it is plus. Then if you are going to apply KVL, minus VCE plus minus IC into RC plus VCC equal to 0. Minus VCE minus VCE. Then current direction is opposite, minus IC RC. Then last component, that is VC, VCC, that is plus 14. Plus 14, that is equal to 0. Already given here, it is IC is 0 because this circuit is open circuit. So IC is 0. So minus ICRC, this one becomes 0. Then what is VCE? VCE is 14 volt. So when the transistor in cutoff region, the voltage we are giving at VCC, that entire voltage will comes across the transistor. So you just give only 1 volt, but you are getting 14 volt at output. But your current is 0. Here you had 1 milliampere current, but now you have 0 current. So this point you can mark as 14, 0. This point you can mark as like that. Then imagine you increase the voltage. That is, again, here you increase the voltage. Now you be taking this one as 2 voltage. Then, for 2 voltage, correspondingly, you will get 2 milliampere current. Then, this transistor, the first case we have taken as open circuit. Now, it is not short circuit, but its resistance start to decrease. Decrease means very high resistance is present here. Very high resistance means it will permit only very small value of current, but it is permitting. Means for 2 milliampere, IB1 is 2 milliampere. You are getting a small voltage almost here. Say it is 13 voltage. So initially we said it is 14, 0. Then now it is, we are saying as 13. The voltage here it is 13. Correspondingly, we are seeing one current here. Say it is 4 milliampere. So 13 volt and 4 milliampere. So automatically you can see you gave 2 volt 2 milliampere, but you are getting 13 volt and 4 milliampere at output. That is, current is increasing. Voltage is decreased from 14 to 13, but again from 2 to 2 it is increased to 13. If you increase this is to, instead of 2 volt, say it is 3 volt. Then now it becomes 3 milliampere. That is IB2. IB2 is 3 milliampere. Corresponding, imagine that this resistance value is decreased. Again, resistance value is decreased. It is allowing more current. More current means near to 10 milliampere current is flowing through here. And correspondingly, voltage is decreased. Since resistance is decreased, current is increased and voltage is decreased. That is 12 volt. So when you are giving 3 volt, you are getting 12 volt. Means gain is, voltage gain is, it is 4. But current, only 2 milliampere current, you are getting 10 milliampere. Means 5 times current is increased. Initially current gain, there is no any current gain. You are giving current, but there is no any output current. So when you are moving from here to here, current gain is increasing, voltage gain is decreasing. And if you are giving very high voltage, say it is instead of 3, you are giving 5 volt, 5 millivolt or 10 mil, say 20 millivolt. You are giving here it is 20 millivolt. Then by that time, the current maybe reaches to this value, say 50 milliampere. That is, this transistor going to become a short circuit. Then entire current, that is 14 by RC, that is 14 by 233 ohm, 14 by 233 ohm, that is actually 60 milliampere. Those entire 60 milliampere is flowing through here. Since it is short circuit, the voltage across these two terminals will be zero. So, can you imagine what happens here? Actually, what happens here? When you are changing the current, input current, how you are changing the input current? When you are changing the input voltage, correspondingly, input current is changing. That is, IB is changing. When IB is changing, correspondingly, output current is changing. That is, biasing. Two junctions were reverse bias here. From there, it is become one junction is forward bias, second junction is reverse bias. And the reverse bias junction, its reverse bias is decreasing from here to here. That is, transistor, you know, it has three region and emitter base collector and two junction. So in cutoff region, these two junctions are reverse bias. Emitter base junction and base collector junction, both are reverse bias. When you are in active region, emitter base junction is forward bias, collector base junction is reverse bias. Here it is reverse bias. But its reverse bias is decreasing when we are moving from here to here. Gradually this resistance is decreasing. When this resistance is decreasing, correspondingly, the current we are getting at output is increasing, voltage we are getting output is decreasing. So when you are changing the input current, correspondingly output current is increasing. When you are decreasing the input current, output current is decreasing. Or in other words, when you are increasing the input current, output voltage is decreasing. Clear? When you are increasing the input current, when IB increases, correspondingly IC increases. But when IB increases, VCE decreases. Means input current increases, correspondingly output current increases. Input current increases, output voltage decreases. So there is a relation like that. So when you are giving input signal, corresponding high amplitude output signal you are getting. This one you can imagine like a operation of a tap pipe. This is emitter. This one is collector. Here it is emitter. And this point is base. So when you completely close the tap, there won't be any current. That is, i.e. this current will be zero. But the entire potential, the force that is stored here, that is sender voltage. When you are completely open the pipe, the entire current will be, that is water will be flow through here. Then the force will be minimum here. You can understand that one like this. That is, like this, base, emitter and collector. So like that it is acting. Then imagine one more thing. If you are just oscillating this tab, that is you are closing opening. The same change will be coming at the output. The water is increasing, decreasing. That is actually basic working of an amplifier for AC signal. Thank you.